My name is Dacia Clay. I'm the audio librarian here at Classical 91.7. While I'm a real librarian, I have a deep, dark secret. I know very little about classical music. I grew up listening to rock, and I know something about jazz. But when it comes to classical, the thing is, I want to learn. And as it turns out, I work with people who know a lot about classical music. Every week on this show, one of my coworkers will give me a homework assignment, a piece of classical music they think I should know, and then we'll discuss it. Come learn with me in the classical classroom. Hi, and welcome to a classical classroom research presentation. I'm Dacia Clay. In this presentation, we'll look at how a song written by a Russian composer to commemorate his country's defense against Napoleon's army became the song for the United States' most patriotic annual celebration. Turns out, just a little bit of good old-fashioned pyromania and Walter Cronkite. It all started long ago in a galaxy far, far away. It was Boston, 1974.
No, surely not, no. No one was alive then.
And Arthur Fiedler, who was then 78 years old, was the conductor for the Boston Pops Orchestra. He had a good and very wealthy young friend named David Mugar, who was then 34 years old. So, like any eccentric pair of Harold and Maudlian friends, they had an interesting hobby. They liked to listen to police radio for fires in the area. Whenever they heard of one, they'd hightail it on over to watch the firefighters fight the blaze. Mr. Mugar became concerned with attendance at the Boston Pops Esplanade concerts, which were these free public outdoor shows that the orchestra played during the summertime. And he wanted to do something to help. Not surprisingly, his mind went immediately to fire. Mr. Fiedler usually conducted an Esplanade concert around July 4th, and David suggested that for this year's performance, the orchestra might play the 1812 Overture. As it turned out, Tchaikovsky's original composition of the 1812 Overture actually calls for cannon fire and the ringing of church bells. By the way, Tchaikovsky himself never got to hear the piece performed this way, possibly because it was logistically very ambitious for his time, and possibly because Alexander II was assassinated the year that the piece was meant to debut, which kind of took the wind out of Russia's collective celebratory sails. So, in Tchaikovsky's crazy musical notation, Mr. Mugar saw his opportunity to help the Boston Pops. They'd have a live performance of the overture, complete with church bells and explosions, and he'd pay for it. But why stop there? Throw in some fireworks at the end. He asked Mr. Fiedler if he thought a fireworks display could be properly coordinated, to which Mr. Fiedler said, "Oh, don't worry about it. Just let all hell break loose at the end of the piece." And so he did. And then the next year, he tried to do it even better. By the third year, it was 1976, the U.S.'s bicentennial, and with 400,000 attendees, the event broke the Guinness Book of World Records record as the best-attended classical concert. CBS did a special that year on the July 4th celebrations all across the U.S., and at the very end, they featured the Boston Pops event. Walter Cronkite said, "It was perhaps a high point of a day marked by crescendos." And so, an American tradition took off, appropriately like wildfire. Mr. Mugar funded the event out of his own pocket for 27 years, until it finally got pricey enough that it required sponsors. At 74, he still produces the event in Boston. This year marks his 40th fourth with the Boston Pops. Even though Tchaikovsky didn't personally care for the piece, he said he wasn't about festival pieces and thought that the overture was going to be, quote, "very loud and noisy, but without artistic merit, because I wrote it without warmth and without love." Thanks to David Mugar, on the 4th, crowds all across the U.S. will attend fireworks displays set to the tune of a great Russian composer. Sorry, Peter. Like any good research paper writer, I've documented my references. To learn more about Tchaikovsky, the 1812 Overture, the Boston Pops, and David Mugar, head on over to classical917.org and click on the Classical Classroom link. Have a happy 4th, and we'll catch you next time.